Hey everyone, Jason Shepard here, MzeroA.com. Just finished my run-up. Taxing over to hold short for 2-3 at the Williston Airport. And going to show you a short field takeoff, followed by a short field landing. Nice little lap in the traffic pattern here. I'm sharing the pattern with one other that just departed. I'm watching it for a bit here. I don't see anybody on final. I'm going to angle out that way still and look. Everything looks great. And when doing a short field takeoff, it's important to consult our POH, where flaps supposed to be, all these little line items here. I'm going to go ahead and make a radio call. Let them know we're departing. And Williston traffic, 2-3 Mike Zulu's departing runway 23 for closed traffic at Williston. All right. I'm going to cross that hold short line. I like to use, and I teach using every bit of runway. So we're going to come all the way over here, simulating this is a real short field. We're at a place like Cedar Key or somewhere that's real short. I'm going to use every bit of runway here.
Crosswind for runway number 23, Williston.
He's on crosswind. Come out after using every bit of runway. Confirm 23, 23, 23. I see it outside, both inside. Smoothly applying full power here. Holding the brakes, engine gauges confirm green, green, and evenly off those brakes. Rolling here, we're going to rotate about 5 knots sooner, and we're going to climb out at VX. Here we go, rotating sooner, there's our speed. Up, up, up. Looking good, climbing out VX. Clear of our obstacle, let's say, as we pass through 50 feet and lowering that nose to a nice VY climb. And at this point, if you had flaps, according to your POH, flaps probably about 10 degrees, you'd be babying those flaps up and out. Continuing to depart out, I had a very aggressive climb here. I want to now that I'm back to VY, make sure I maintain center line out, maybe even taking a peek back, making sure everything is good there as I continue to fly out. And then we're going to come around and I'm going to put it right down on the numbers 2-3, and I'm going to talk you through that process as well. So follow along with me in the traffic pattern here as I show you what that traffic pattern looks like and how we're preparing to land in a short field. Now, the problem is, let me make a radio call real quick first. Williston traffic, 2-3 Mike Zulu's turn left crosswind, runway 2-3, full stop, Williston traffic. Looking and turning crosswind. The problem is, we simulate a short field two ways. Sometimes we'll say, I'm clearing an obstacle and I have to come in and hit a specific point. Sometimes it's just truly a short field and there are no obstacles. Maybe it's like the Cedar Key Airport, which is just beach on either side. There's no obstacles, but you just need to come in slow to be able to slow down in time is what it really is. The secret to this, and it's just like a normal landing, that airspeed is king in this case. As I turn downwind, and I'm doing that now, and Williston traffic, 2-3 Mike Zulu is turning left downwind, runway 23, full stop, Williston. All right, turning downwind here. I don't want to let my airspeed get away from me. I already have a tailwind. I don't want to let it get away from me. So my RPMs, I'm actually back to 2,000 RPMs right now, which is much less than a cruise RPM setting. I've got a trim for that. I'm flying hands-free for the most part through this turn and everything else. Letting the airplane work with me and for me in this case. Not letting my air... I'm in the flap arc right now for full flaps if I wanted to.
Downwind at Williston. Are you the only guy in the pattern right now, sir?
No, sir. You have one more ahead of me. I believe he's on a base.
Okay, and that's who I'm worried about. Okay, I'm on the ground ready for takeoff. I'll wait for him.
Bye. And that's what happens when everybody steps on everybody like that.
For runway number 23, Williston.
I got him out in front of me here.
Okay, sir.
Now, this is going to be interesting here, too, because in a perfect world, I'd want to start my landing here, you know, beam my touchdown point, carpeat power back, 10 degrees of flaps, but I've got traffic out here base.
I've got the traffic.
Now I've got to extend out and adjust my pattern a little bit to this traffic here. I got one departing, I got one on base, and then, by the way, Mr. Ms. Check Right Examiner, you expect me to hit my point. See, things aren't always perfect, or as they seem, are they? I'm going to start a very, very slow descent. Carbine on, just bringing back another 100, 200 RPMs. Because I really don't like to actually start my turn and my descent in until he's abeam me on final. So I always say a perfect landing starts with a perfect traffic pattern. A perfect pattern's not always an option now, is it here? He just departed. I've got him out here on base. He's turn final.
Zulu turning final for 2-3, Williston.
I'm abeam him now. I'm going power back.
Full stop, Williston.
I'm going 10 degrees of flaps here. and I'm just managing my, I'm 90 right now.
Traffic,
right where I
want to
be. I don't want to ride his butt, though, and get too close.
I mean, maintain traffic,
so
or the
now I'm turning my base.
Runway heading.
Wilson, traffic 23, Mike Salou's left base, 23, full stop, Wilson. Oh, someone stepped on me. And 23, Mike Salou's left base, 23, Wilson. I knew someone stepped on me because I heard him at the last second, which means no one heard anything. That's why I made that radio call again here. This is good. This wasn't the intention of this lesson, to make it a radio communication slash dealing with other traffic in the pattern lesson. Now, wait till you see what I'm seeing here in just a second. I am way out on final, and you're thinking, somehow I have to still hit this point when I'm flying this big old, you know, bomber-style traffic pattern, but this could happen on a check ride. You don't always get the perfect traffic pattern with no one in there. You don't always ATC, or if you're in a towered field, doesn't always vector you for the perfect little approach here. I haven't added any more flaps. I'm going to save that for as soon as I turn final here. He's over airport proper now. I've slowed down to about 85. And Wilson, traffic 23, Mike Zulu's turning an extended final. Long final for 23, Wilson traffic. Let him know, I don't want to scare him and say, hey, I'm turning final when he's over the airport fence. Let him know I'm an extended final, I'm a long final, so he knows I'm out here, and I don't want him to feel pressured to rush either here. I'm even kind of trying to round this turn on through, if you can see, to buy him some time, but still my focus is, by the way, I want to hit those numbers 2-3. You have to, in aviation, be willing to adapt, be willing to adjust. You know, I was presented this situation, it might behoove you to fly a bigger pattern and still try to hit your point here. Airspeed's king. I want to be about 80 right now, and I'm going to need another 10 degrees of flaps to pull that off.
35440, clear runway number 23.
He's clear.
Back to 23, Wilson.
He's clear. Runway's mine. I'm looking. I'm slowing to 75. Everything's looking good. I'm putting, in this seat, I put the center line on my chest. In the, if you're sitting in the left seat, you're putting that center line on your right shoulder. Left seat, center line, right shoulder is going to help you a lot. Speed's really, really great. I'm holding 75 right here. I only have 20 degrees of flaps, and I'm holding 75, right? That's pretty good here. I'm going to get some more flaps in a little bit closer here. I don't like to make a lot of adjustments. I'm at full flaps now. Babying it on back. Coming in over airport property at 70. Coming on in, and know your numbers for your airplane, know your POH. I am aiming ahead of my touchdown point. I'm aiming about 100 feet in front of the numbers 2-3. Basically, I'm aiming for the end of the runway here. I'm coming in. Everything's looking good. Looking good. Hold it off. Don't touch down before your point. Hold it off. Hold it off. Hold it off. 2-3. And put her down. Just like that. And short field, aerodynamic braking, right? Back on the yoke, apply the brakes. They don't like you fiddling around with a whole lot here, but if you have the time and the thought, you bring the flaps up as well. Now, in retractable gear aircraft, they don't like you touching any switches down there, but in this, it's okay to reach down, grab those flaps, and aerodynamic braking to slow us down and make that first turnoff. I'll get beyond the whole short line here, clean up the airplane, and then can't wait to read your comments down underneath this video on MZeroA.com. Just always looking to learn something new. So listen, and enjoy the rest of your day. And most importantly, remember, a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya.
I wrote the Private Pilot Blueprint with the intention of, if I could do my flight training over, would I wish someone would have told me? And I want that book to be yours for free. All I ask is that you pay shipping. Visit PrivatePilotBlueprint.com to get your free copy.